गाइज, वेलकम बैक टू माई यूट्यूब चैनल। सो टुडे वाइल रनिंग आई रियलाइज दैट देर इज़ नो सच इन्फॉर्मेशन ऑन द नेट अबाउट LLM इन कैनेडा एंड वट आर द प्रोज एंड कॉन्स ऑफ डूइंग इट। आई हैड डन माई ओन रिसर्च वैन आई वॉज थिंकिंग अबाउट डूइंग द NCA फर्स्ट और डूइंग द LLM और वट कोर्स शुड आई चूज। सो माई रिसर्च आई एम शेयरिंग विद यू गाइज। आई होप यू लाइक इट एंड शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब टू माई चैनल सो दैट आई एम ऑल्सो वेरी मच मोटिवेटेड टू शेयर ऑल दिस इन्फॉर्मेशन दैट आई हैव इन माई पिटारा विद यू गाइज। एंड सो सबसे पहले मैं आपको दिखाती हूँ आज रनिंग की ट्रेल मेरे घर के पास वो कैसी है। सो गाइज, LLM पे तो मेरे पास इतनी इन्फॉर्मेशन और रिसर्च है कि आई हैड टू कट शॉर्ट दिस होल वीडियो बिकॉज आई हैव रिसर्च। आई कैन ब्लैबर अबाउट 50 मिनट्स ऑन दिस बट आई विल ट्राई टू डिस्कस सम पॉइंट्स विद यू। दिस इज़ नॉट एन इवेल्यूएशन ऑफ वॉट आई सजेस्ट यू डू बट इट इज़ एन इवेल्यूएशन फॉर वॉट यू शुड बी डूइंग अकॉर्डिंग टू योर ओन सर्कमस्टांसिस एंड योर ओन मटीरियली प्रोफेशनल ग्रोथ वेर एवर यू आर इन लाइफ, राइट। सो सब मैंने कुछ पॉइंट जॉट डाउन कर लिए हैं एंड आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस विद यू ऑल ऑफ दैम। सो द फर्स्ट पॉइंट अबाउट मास्टर्स ऑफ लॉ इन कैनेडा इज दैट इट इज़ अ वेरी ईजी वे टू इमिग्रेट टू कैनेडा। येस गाइज, यू गेट अ स्टूडेंट वीज़ा एंड देन यू गेट एन ओपन वर्क परमिट। देर आफ्टर बिकॉज ऑफ दैट एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ वर्क इन कैनेडा यू डू गेट सम पॉइंट्स ऑल्सो एंड बिकॉज ऑफ योर मास्टर्स ऑल्सो यू गेट सर्टन पॉइंट्स इन योर एक्सप्रेस एंट्री एंड दिस होल थिंग हेल्प्स यू टू इमिग्रेट टू कैनेडा। सो आई हैव सीन सो मेनी पीपल हु यूज दिस रूट टू कम टू कैनेडा एंड देन दे थिंक दैट ओके आफ्टर दैट दे आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद देयर professional career. So you can think of it as a way to immigrate as well. The second point I think we should keep in mind is that any kind of masters or any kind of specialization, it is very good for people who want an in-depth knowledge of a particular subject. So supposingly you are a securities professional or you are a banking professional or you are a professional say in commercial arbitration or any kind of profession that you have been doing in law, then you want to study that subject more because now you have your area of practice. Now supposingly for somebody like me who's still trying to think that, you know, okay, I like litigation, but still trying to figure out which area of litigation and what else can I do, and still trying to figure my area of space, if you know what I mean, then an in-depth knowledge, I think for me right now would create a barrier for me. So I need to explore all my options. In short, what I'm trying to say is that your masters may be making restricting yourself rather than widening your horizons. So you have to see it is if it is good for you according to your professional career. But for somebody like me who's a fresher and who's just started with her career in Canada, so you can imagine that I am still looking for opportunities. So the third point is that academically, people who want to go into a professionally academic career, then this is the stepping point for you. You know what exactly happens is when you get into a Masters of Law program, you meet, network and get along with your professors and your mentors, and then you start writing research paper because I think you're supposedly also supposed to write some research paper. So you start writing that kind of paper, you know what is legal research is, and then your stepping career like a stepping stone starts towards your academic career. So this is a very good profession for people who want to you can say go into academics or who are looking for a change in field. So supposingly you've been, you know, doing something in your life and now you want to shift that area of practice and you want that kind of tag to be detached from you, so you can look for an LLM in an area of interest maybe that you have. So also I think when you choose your LLM, you have to be very careful as to what kind of LLM is good for you in that particular country and in that particular area where you want to. So many people come outside and do their Masters of Law and then thereafter go back, right? They take their degree back to their home and use it there. My one more suggestion is that when you are looking for a for a university where from where you have to do your LLM, you should make sure that you are looking at the campus placement as well. You should know that that kind of university has a campus placement cell and you know it is offering good jobs. I think many people miss this point and you like the UFT is one of the Canada's best university to do your Masters of Law, but then they have the very good campus placement cell as well. They say that 96 to 97% the graduates from there are hired in the recruitment. So you have to make sure that you are looking at a broader picture, not just about the course, but about the U campus. And also UFT campuses are around downtown. You have the areas of, you know, you have the opportunity to network and to meet people, because many of the professors are legal practitioners. Now, many people spend so much financially on this whole degree and then they think that they can practice law. Guys, this is not true. NCA, to practice law in Canada, NCA, your province eligibility requirements and getting your bar certificate and stuff, the whole process is different from doing your master's of law. Until and unless your LLM university does not specifically tell you that yes, they have courses which are NCA certification, till that time you are not supposed to automatically think that LLM is good enough for you to practice law. No, you will have to do your LLM. Thereafter, you will also have to maybe side along, or maybe thereafter, whatever suits you, but you have to do your NCA and your accreditation and your equivalency process. So the process is different and your LLM is different. So the job people, a lot of time people ask me that what is the job market after LLM. I have not done LLM, but according to my insight with people who are doing LLM and who have given it to me, is like that it is a stepping stone. No doubt you get ahead, step ahead, but you are just a step ahead than the person. Maybe the person who's done JD or who's done law has better opportunity in job market because of the practice experience. So the practical experience really matters in practice rather than a master's. What happens is that you may have an in-depth knowledge of the subject, but you do not have the practical hands-on experience to use it. So to in advancement of that particular job market that people ask me, I always say that practice is more important to get into job market. And then I have seen so many people who get sponsored to do their masters of law by their particular firm, by the particular employer. One point I think which I have done my research on and which I would like to share with you guys is that in Canada, energy, mining law and natural resources law and environmental law is still very upcoming and very area which is not really exploited as for now, and in the future it has a good chance. So that is what the report says. So I think University of Calgary offers the Masters of Law in this natural resources, mining and energy sector. So you can go on the website. I'm sharing the link in the description box and you can check out if you want to do that Masters of Law. One more thing that I think I should share with you guys is that you should also take this in account that a master's for a permanent resident is one third the cost of a master's for an international student. So many people also first try to become a permanent resident in Canada and then pursue master's. So it really depends on your financial capacity and backing, but you should always keep this in mind that you might be paying 30,000, for which a PR might be paying 15,000 to 14,000. So guys, these were few of the points I thought should be helpful for you guys. I think I will be doing one webinar or Zoom session with a person who is more expert in Masters of Law so that you have some real insights, and that is the whole point of this channel. So I hope you like it, and if you do like this video, hit the like button, share and subscribe because it makes it recommending. And thank you. Bye-bye.